Let me turn on this light first. There. Okay, so how to get perfect skin tones in DaVinci Resolve 17? That's what we're talking about today. What? What are you looking at? Do I have something on my face? Okay, so the cool thing about the technique that I'm going to show you is that all the color adjustments that we'll do will only affect the skin tones, because let's say you want a classic teal and orange look. What you don't want is the skin to look teal or too orange. Skin tones should look natural. So I'll show you a simple technique that will allow you to do the color grading and skin tone adjustments separately. The node workflow in DaVinci Resolve 17 makes it, I'm not gonna say super easy, but you know, if you practice it a few times, once you get the hang of it, it's not that difficult. Okay, we're in DaVinci Resolve 17 and I'm using the studio version, but remember guys, you can also do this in the free version, no problem. You don't need any of the paid features. Now, the first thing you need to do is color correct your log image. If you're working with log footage, that is, of course. Either apply a Rec. 709 LUT or do it manually. Usually that means adding contrast and making sure that the white balance is correct. You know, make sure that the image looks natural. I'm gonna skip that step now because there's plenty of tutorials that explain how to do it. I'll link a few in the description. So, the first two nodes are my color correction nodes to make the image look natural. Next, we're going to work on the skin tones. Add another node, option S, or right click and add a corrector node. And now we're gonna select the skin tones in the qualifier tab here. Select the color picker and then select the skin tones. Then hit Shift H. Now DaVinci shows you the selection. Now, there are different ways to fine-tune your selection. It depends on the image, really. Sometimes one click with the color picker is all it takes, but usually it needs some manual fine-tuning. I'll show you a few different ways. First thing you can do is select the picker Add To here and add more tones to the selection. The feather tool here you can use to blend the selection to make it softer. You don't want rough edges around your selection, because it will show in the final result. You can also use the hue, saturation or luminance bar to fine-tune the selection. My beard, for example, I don't want too much of my beard in the selection. If I make the luminance range smaller, see how it removes my beard from the selection? You can also use clean white and clean black. Clean black, again, will add or remove dark black tones from the selection. So, depending on the image, you'll have to play around with the settings here. And, you know, in most cases, it doesn't matter if there's some background areas added to the selection. Okay, and finally, of course, you can soften the selection with the denoise slider. This looks pretty good, I think. Then we need the vector scope and make sure that you can see the skin tone line. You can activate the skin tone line here in the settings, and what you want now is the skin tones on that line or slightly above. The easiest way to check that is to add a circular power window over a small part of the skin tones. Right now there's too much red in the skin tones. So let's fix that. Go to the color wheels, make sure you're in the log wheel tab. First, let's bring the skin tones on that line using the offset. Just a little bit. See how I'm pulling the skin tones toward that line? Let's check. Looks better. Now, you can do a lot more if you want. If there's still too much red in the face, you can get rid of that. Go to the curves and hue versus hue. Then select the reddest part of the skin. And here you see those two dots? That represents the red areas that you will adjust. See how I can tighten the range here in the vector scope? So I'm actually changing the hue of the red tones more toward yellow. But don't overdo it, because the more you start poking around here, the more fake your skin will look. You have to find a balance. I'm just gonna leave it like it was. Okay, and then back to the log wheels. Another thing you can do is add some more skin tone color in the midtones. Just push more of those skin tones into the midtones. So basically, you're pushing the midtones along the skin tone line. And sometimes I like to push a tad of red in the shadows also. So it's looking pretty good, looks natural. The difference is not that crazy here because it's a controlled environment, but let's say you're shooting in a forest. The reflection from the leaves and the trees might make your skin tones look greenish, and then you'll see a big difference if you use this technique. Okay, now we're done working on the skin tones. Now let's say I want to do a teal and orange color grade. Let's do a simple one. Remove the power window, hit Shift H to show the whole image, add another node. In this node, I'm gonna add a bit of contrast, not too much, and then another node. And here I'll do a quick teal and orange grade, so in the curves. Let's take some of the red away in the shadows, this will add teal. Also add some blue in the shadows, add a bit of green to the highlights and remove it from the shadows. Something like that. Super easy, simple, fast. Problem now is that my teal and orange grade also affected the skin tones, and I don't want that because it doesn't look healthy. Let's fix that. Super easy, select the node with the color grade and hit Option or Alt plus L. This will add a layer node. Now all we need to do is connect the blue triangle from the skin tone adjustment node to the layer node. And now the skin tone adjustments are layered on top of the color grade. So your skin tones are not affected by that color grade. And it could be that it's reversed. Then just go to key and hit this icon here to reverse the qualifier selection. See, the skin tones are not affected by that teal and orange grade. Now look, depending on how heavy your color grade is, let's exaggerate a little bit. There, it could be that the skin tones are too clean compared to the grade. What you can do then is go to key and lower the output gain. Now you're blending the skin tone adjustments with the color grade. And just stop until you have a nice balance. And that's it. Complete control over the skin tones. Now, the first time you try this, it might look a bit overwhelming and difficult, but just practice it a few times. The key is to understand that node workflow, and especially the layer nodes. Just watch this tutorial 10 times, and you'll be fine. And that's also good for my watch time. Okay, and then if you have questions, of course, you know where to find me. Drop it in the comments, send me an email. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Subscribe to the like button and see you in the next one.